Hi, this is Sean, and in this video we're going to go over the very basic Maya to UDK FBX workflow. So we're going to talk about making sure double checking your scale is correct, hardening and softening edges, making sure your shaders export correctly, and then when you get into UDK we'll talk about UDK packages. Alright, let's get started in Maya. So in Maya I've got this chair which we talked about in the last video. Before you export it, I always delete the history. So the hotkey is Shift Alt D to delete history. I also make sure that I've frozen transforms, and that makes sure that the scale's all set to 1 and the translation rotation are all set to 0. So for example, if this had been scaled up about 20%, I would just go under Modify Freeze Transforms, and that zeros and ones, everything's out. Next, I would make sure that I have my UVs all set up. So you can see that I've got my UVs laid out and they're all packed into the 0 to 1 space. So I've double checked that none of them are flipped. UDK can handle texture sets, and we'll go over that in another video. So I can show my texture on the object. One of the thoughts that I had was maybe I would want to make this edge right around here soft, and one of the things UDK can handle is specified edge normal bending, which is, you know, softening or hardening edges. I already made a quick select set for that edge. If you ever need to do that, you can select geometry, edges, and go under create quick select sets. And if you want to access those quick select sets, you go under the edit menu. And then the fast way is Shift right click, soften harden edge. I'm going to choose soften edge. You can see that it's bent the surface normals to create a much softer edge. All right, so let's talk about the pivot point. The pivot point is usually specified in Maya by where you identify where it is. But in the FBX workflow, it will specify where the origin of the object is. So if I wanted the chair to have a pivot point in its center, I would just nudge it down here. Since I want the pivot point to be at the base, I'm fine with it where it is. Maybe I would even have the pivot point on the back legs. So let's check that out and export that. So with the textures that I have set up for this object, I want to make sure the textures are all set at powers of 2. In this case, there are 1024 by 1024 textures. But as long as they're a power of 2, they could be 512s by 512, 256 by 256, that would be fine. I think you could even go so far as having a 4K texture. Make sure, this is important, make sure that you name your textures correctly. I have exported UDK textures, and every once in a while it's possible to forget, and you will overwrite your texture names if they have the same names. So that's something to be very careful about. So we have the object named. I'm going to re-delete the history, and I'm going to export this object. So you need to make sure that the FBX is turned on in the plugin menu. If it's not, that would be under Settings and Preferences. And you would look for the FBX to Maya.mll. And then we go to File, Export, Selection. If I haven't already specified this, I would want to edit the presets. I want to turn on smoothing groups, and that will sort of allow me to specify whether or not my edges are soft or hard. So that's already saved. And I'm going to export the selection. Now I'm going to go into UDK, and I'm going to pull open the content browser, and I'm going to import my object. So here I have several chairs that I've exported. I'm going to double click, I'm going to import. Now it will ask you what package you want to import. If you haven't created a package for your project yet, this is where all of your custom assets and textures and morphs and everything will go in, and you'll give it a name, and you'll give your objects a name and make sure that you have by default, it should import textures and materials with the objects and say OK to all. If it doesn't, it will create a package called My Package and create a folder for you. So it will take a second as it imports. It will generate a material for it'll generate a shader for the materials that you're creating. And here we are in My Package. And we've got a normal spec and color, and then I also have a UDK material that it generated. And here is the object itself. So we can double check that, drag it on. You can see it has no collision model associated with it. So that's one of the things I'm going to go over in the next video. But before we end this, I'm going to save the package that I've created. So you can select the package and hit Control S. And what you're going to do is save the mic package file. So I have a package called My Package. And it will save as a u.upk file. So what I would like you to do for this class is save your UPK package and make sure it's saved in the content subfolder of UDK, which should be the default. So when I test your levels, I will put all of your package files and your UDK files in this folder to test them. And that's it for today. Thanks so much for watching.